So next, I would like to invite Darshana Jain, CEO Isma Future Tech, with Naresh Jain, CEO and co-founder, and along with their customer Kushal, is a social skill organization to present the credential platform Snapchat. Over to you, Darshana and team.
Thank you so much, Kamlesh. Pleasure to be here today. I am the CEO of Snapchat Future Tech. My name is Darshana Jain. So we actually took the liberty to invite our customer to talk about the use case today with us. And we aim to talk about the use case for a credential verification platform today. And the credential verification platform is used by universities, colleges, schools to issue degree certificates and verify them. So that is a fairly common use case for blockchain today. The reason to invite Kushal as a use case, because it's a very unique scenario, and we'll talk about it as we go forward a little bit. I want to take a couple of minutes and actually introduce what Kushal does, because that's very important for a use case. Kushal is an organization that's dedicated to skilling workers in the construction real estate industry. And they are actually in this domain, it's a big deal because it's a very hard thing to do because nobody wants to take time off of work to get trained. And skilling in Hindi means kushal, and that's what this means. And the whole purpose is to skill the migrant labor that is involved in the construction industry. This is an initiative that is taken by the Developers Association of Pune called CREDAI. And Kushal is partnered with the National Skills Development Corporation, Ministry of Finance, Government of India, and CSDC. These are our government bodies which are involved in skilling India. The need to understand what Kushal does is vital for the purposes of the business case because it offers a first of its kind on-the-job training on the construction sites through its mobile vans. And Kushal has made a mark worldwide. They are actually, they went to the World Skills Competition and have won 3 consecutive years for excellence in bricklaying, and that says a lot. Close to 75,000 workers have been skilled by Kushal, and these 75,000 credentials are available on our platform on blockchain to be verified. There are some core skills that Kushal trains in: bar bending, plumbing, shuttering, tiling, painting, masonry. Again, I'm saying this is important for us to understand what Kushal does, for you to understand the use case as to why it was important for us to tell you what Kushal does. A little bit about the company, what Snapper Future Tech does. Snapper Future Tech is an enterprise solutions company. We do products and platforms using blockchain. We also have an EdTech vertical called Indian Blockchain Institute. We work in various domains: supply chain, healthcare, e-governance, BFSI. SnapCert, which is what we are showcasing today, is part of our e-governance suite. The Indian Blockchain Institute was actually a result of our own need for the company to find blockchain talent. And it kind of was born there, and now it is a tech brand. It's a tech company, which is actually catering towards the world requirement of global talent for blockchain as we all get ready. I invite Kapil Trimal to talk about. So Kapil is part of the Kushal team. He's the joint secretary on the steering committee. And they actually identified the business case and brought it to us that there was something very unique about it, which we needed to address. Kapil? Kapil, you're on mute.
Oh, sorry about that. So for the first time in India, the construction worker was issued a certificate. Now, an instrument that validated the skill level and ensured fair wages. However, construction workers move from site to site, from region to region, and their existence is almost nomadic in nature. So lo and behold, that certificate always gets misplaced. A second is, aside, when the worker presents the certificate to the contractor or the developer, they're immediately very doubtful and worry about the authenticity and the source of the certificate, you know, that they produced. Managing it effectively and retrieving it whenever it's required for decision, for making it available to stakeholders like contractors and developers. From a management perspective, we need data available based on demographics, trade, and various other data points, which can help us become more resourceful and more efficient. And finally, what we need is transparency, you know, the need for a genuine certificate and a secure medium, one that cannot be altered, misplaced, or misused.
So when Kapil and JP sir came to us with this problem, the very unique issue here was that the migrant labor does not have access to smartphones or to any online digital medium for him to produce any certificate, right? Even if they were to store it, let's say, on WhatsApp or any other such medium. And yet they had to prove their credentials, because if they don't, they don't get the raise in wages, which is probably about 30 to 50% hike in their daily wages. And so it was important for us to provide a solution which did not require them to have any digital platform for their verification. What we had to go and do was use the Aadhaar ID, which is the equivalent of a social security number issued in the US, along, and the Aadhaar ID, again, it's a personal identifier. So because of GDPR, obviously we couldn't have that kind of information on the platform. So we had to take the last four digits, make sure that it's unique, use the course, the initial skilling courses that I showed you, along with their name, to create a unique hash for this. So if the laborer went to any construction site and just gave his last four digits and the name, we could pull up the certification. So it really made it easy for them to access. The ROI for each of the stakeholders is immense in this platform. Real-time verification without loss of time. Obviously, it's trusted. There is a huge saving in OPEX for the verifier also, as well as for the institution that is implementing this. And deference to fake certificates for both. For the laborers, it was, again, online and permanent records, anytime, anywhere. And no risk of losing the paper certificates, because they're migrant, they cannot carry, they lose it. We're going to show you a quick demo on the of the platform on how this is done, the actual platform. I'm just going to take a second here. Naresh, you want to help me out here? Okay, one second. Yeah, I got it. Is my screen visible?
Not yet.
Okay. How about now?
Yeah, it's visible now.
We're going to run through a quick demo that Naresh has recorded.
Let us take a look at how Snapchat works and how our customer Kushal is using it. The platform supports three stakeholders: the Academy Institute, who issues the certificate or degree, in this case, Kushal; the verifier, in this case, construction contractor. It could also be a corporate or an individual verifier. And the third stakeholder is a recipient of the credential, in this case, the migrant labor. The credential recipient for Kushal is a migrant labor who is uneducated. They may not be able to preserve the physical copy of training certification issued. Kushal adopted Snapcert platform to ensure ease for contractors to verify skilling credentials based on his name and the last four digits of his Aadhaar ID. Aadhaar ID is the Indian version of the social security number issued in US. Verifier will register on the Snapcert portal and signs in. Contractor can then verify a credential on the certificate by using certificate ID or using metadata. Verifier selects the issuer program name, the type of certificate from the predefined list, and enter ID and name given by the candidates. If the incorrect data is entered, an error message is displayed. If the credential is verified, then it displays the certificate data and PDF file of the original certificate can be viewed. In case of tampering, or if the credential is removed or displaced from the primary source, then SnapCert detects the same and displays the error message. SnapCert provides end-to-end certificate generation and verification process for all kinds of credentials, including micro-credentials. The SnapCert platform adheres to the GDPR standards and maintains data protection and privacy for our customers. Thank you.
So that's the use case in short for with Kushal. There are multiple universities also on the platform which are able to verify the credentials, issue credentials, attest, issue duplicates, and go through the entire credential lifecycle. We also are able to issue micro-credentials, which is badges, essentially. Naresh, JP sir?
Yeah. So thank you, Darshana. In fact, as Kushal has always been pioneers in doing something unique, and when Darshana came up with this proposal, we're absolutely, surprised. And if this could be done, I could see the potential where 5 crore construction workers genuinely needed this kind of a service so that they are able to really get the wage they could get after being skilled. Being on the board of the Construction Sector Skills Council, I realized the impact this could have on what would be achieved post the skilling is done. So it's a brilliant idea, and we are glad that SnapCert could come out with a solution that was very easy to access and very doable. And I think it's great future. So congratulations to SnapCert, and I think it's going to be a big thing for the industry, particularly where skilled, unskilled laborers who do not have such access are really going to benefit, not only in terms of wage enhancements, but also in terms of financial inclusions that shall follow with such data security and data availability. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Appreciate the time taken for the business case here. We are open to any questions.
Yeah. Thank you, Darshana, and thank you, Kushal and Naresh. So there are one question regarding the platform offered as a SaaS. So how the personal identity information data handled? Means kind of GDPR compliance.
Yeah. Okay. So let me take up that question. There are two parts here. First of all, whatever verification we do verification at the primary source. We do not store any certificate on our platform. We do not store any personal information on our platform. So we are connected with the customer's database, and we act like a bridge between verifier and the certificate issuer. So between them, the certificate is there, platform is there, and whenever verification is to be done, it directly goes to the customer system database and verifies it. And what we do on blockchain is mainly we store hashes. So we are not storing any kind of personal information on our platform.
Yeah, okay, thank you. And next question regarding the who is the kind of hosting a node, DLT node in the solution?
Here we have created a multi-hosting environment, and each university, basically they have optional, like in case of Kushal has not adopted that because it's not that and that large organization, but in future that's what we are discussing right now. But generally each university has an option to host a node, and we are open for any kind of cloud server. So we have 4 different kind of nodes which are separately managed on different clouds. Apart from that, one node which is given one optional to each university. And yeah, it's a multi-hosting environment.
Yeah, so thank you. Thank you for the presentation. So, yeah.
Thank you
so much for having us, Amresh.
Yeah.